NBA action on EA Sports. I'm Ed Cohen. Great to be joined by Jay Williams for what should be a terrific matchup here tonight. From AT&T Center in San Antonio, tonight, the San Antonio Spurs taking on the Philadelphia 76ers. Philadelphia controls the tap. Simmons to Embiid. From the outside, no good. Murray into the front court. He'll run the offense. Has a chance. And the rebound to Johnson. Here's Simmons with it up top. Looking to make something happen. Pass to the rim. Joel Embiid missed his first. That one goes.
Can we take a second to talk about the most gregarious personality in the NBA? We don't trust in the process. No. We're beyond the process. Joel Embiid has emerged as this generation's Shaquille O'Neal, and he's done it in a variety of ways. He's a dominant big who doesn't shy away from the physicality of the game. Probably the reason why he was up for Defensive Player of the Year. And also, he has a personality that baits you into a conversation, whether you like it or not. And he's pretty hysterical. This kid is going to be a star in the league for years to come, and you better pay attention to what he has to put down.
Butler matched up with DeRozan. To Embiid. Shot from the lane won't go. Rudy Gay to DeRozan. To Rudy Gay. Over to the right side. Fires the three. DeJounte Murray keeps getting better. That was a tough three.
Man, you making people dance out there? I see you with the footwork.
Simmons with it. They trail by one. To Embiid. Pau Gasol with the block. LaMarcus Aldridge sends it away. Right now, San Antonio's possession. Almost, and he's not getting the call. To Embiid. From the painted area, won't go down. Sixers have it. Simmons to Butler. And it's Gasol with the rebound. Murray into the front court. Leads just a point. To DeRozan. Trying to cash in. Open look, and he buries it. Defense has to wake up.
You see, you can't actually get mesmerized by the ball. You actually have to focus on the dribbler's belly button. I know that may sound cheesy, but trust me, he can't go anywhere without his core.
No, I missed a short one there. Murray with it. Up by three. To DeRozan. And that one out of bounds off a spur. Time to shuffle things up.
For San Antonio, number 8, Patty Mills.
Simmons with it. Down three. To Embiid. Won't go. The Spurs have the board. To DeRozan. Aldridge. To DeRozan. Lets it fly from long range. His first effort. Off the mark. To Simmons. Pau Gasol snatching it out of the air. Second block in this quarter. San Antonio with the basketball. DeRozan matched up with Jimmy Butler. Here comes the screen. DeRozan to Gasol. Old school. Backs his man down for the basket.
You feel that? I see the confidence building.
In the front court comes Simmons. Down five. Rudy Gay to DeRozan. Ah, the monster stuff.
That's what I'm talking about. Nice finish. It's all business.
Sixers call for time as they'll go over some tactics now in this first quarter of play. Coach has seen enough. He wants some changes. New personnel onto the floor. Simmons. Now pass stolen by the Spurs. DeRozan. And the two. Counted for Aldridge.
I love the drive to the basket there. Instead of trying to go around or over, go through.
Sixers have the basketball to Simmons. Spurs have it. DeRozan to Murray. Has a look. The shot by Gay, no good. Nice touch around the basket with the tip.
As a player, there's nothing better than coming out in the first quarter and playing exactly the same way you played the last couple of days of practice. You're moving the ball, you're capitalizing on mistakes, and you really built a nice lead.
The assist from number 25, Vincent.
Murray with the basketball. It's a 9-point lead. Rudy Gay to DeRozan. With a drop step. LaMarcus Aldridge. 2 for 2. That's what you want.
Old school equals high percentage.
Simmons. Knocked loose. Picked up by the Spurs. Looking to push. Rudy Gay to Murray. Oh, had him going there for a second. Count the basket at the rim.
This has been quite the redemption story for L.A. In the 2016-17 season, there seemed to be a rift between him and Spurs management. Had a very difficult time finding his way. Wasn't used to being an anchor down low at the post position. But this is the brilliance of Greg Popovich. Sat him down, spoke to him man-to-man multiple times, and got L.A. to buy into something bigger than himself, which is the reason why he is one of the most dominant bigs in the league.
Gasol. To Aldridge. Ah, can't miss those. Butler into the front court. Down 11 to Simmons. It goes down.
You know, I'm going to say something that people probably won't like, but guess what? I don't care. I'm already crowning Ben Simmons as a top 5 playmaker in the league. His first true season, He had 18 points, 8 assists, and 8 rebounds. He could finish around the rim and make everybody else around him look great. There's no doubt about it. He has all the ingredients to be the heir to the throne.
Joel Embiid, a tip shot.
That kid can block out the sun, man.
Spurs have it. Not that time.
See, when good shooters catch, they just shoot. When bad shooters catch, they become hesitant, reluctant. That's the first sign of a guy that doesn't have confidence.
And one. Embiid, good through the contact. And going to the line for a chance at a three-point play.
He should get some kind of acting award. That's a great sell by the offensive player. But guess what? The ref spit, and that's the game.
Joel Embiid at the line for a chance at a three-point play. For his career, 77% at the line. Missed it at the line. To Aldridge. Slam dunk. Jay, they've had no answer for this guy.
He's been on fire this first quarter. That's the way you take it right to your opponent. You attack right out of the gate.
Jakob Poeltl pins it.
That's why a rim protector is a necessity in this game.
Patty Mills to Aldridge. Doesn't have the touch. No good. Simmons into the front court. His team down 9. Had a good look there, but it's no good. Patty Mills down low. Aldridge. LaMarcus Aldridge. With that shot, he's 5 for 8.
They're going to have to find answers defensively and quickly because he's carving them up in the first quarter.
Simmons to Embiid. Won't go down. Defender's lucky he wasn't called. Another follow. No good. Bellinelli matched up with Jimmy Butler. Yes, and a foul. Hell of a chance at a three-point play.
And I know there's so much excitement about the play, but everybody looks at the player. More people need to pay attention to the guy at the end of the bench, the strength and conditioning coach, because this kid's been putting in the time and effort every day in the weight room.
Jimmy Butler trying to cash in on a three-point play. A career 83% free throw shooter. Free throw is good to finish off the three-point play. And the margin down to 8. Embiid. They'll go to Butler down low, and a chance coming up at the line.
You see this all the time. The defensive player is establishing his presence on the court and also checking to see how far the refs are going to let him go.
Jimmy Butler has got 2 shots coming. He's perfect from the line so far. And hits the first free throw. For 2 on that trip. To Aldridge. Scores from the post.
This has been a good first quarter for him so far. That wasn't an easy shot, but he was able to knock it down and add to their lead.
Markel Fultz to Butler. Curling inside. Fultz to Butler. The screen sets him up for 2.
It looks like he's using his ball handling to feel the game out. I know it looks like he's just playing around out there, trying to get the fans going. That is true, but he's also finding his rhythm.
To Aldridge. That's no good.
You see, this is something that everybody has, but some people choose to use it or not. I'm glad you choose to use effort on getting around those screens.
Embiid to Fultz. Going to make some changes with some new personnel on the floor. To Butler.
Watch that back door.
Not that time.
I just love where this takes you into the psychological battle as a player offensively. Was that a great contest, or did you just miss the shot? But now you have me thinking about that the entire next possession.
Nothing going here on that drive. To Butler. From the outside, no good. Short jumper stays out.
It's so important to instill confidence in your best player. I know he missed a shot earlier, but that doesn't mean that you can't run the same exact play and let him prove he's the player he thinks he is and we all know he is.
Nothing going here on that drive. Joel Embiid, huge block. That's out. Last touch by Joel Embiid. Corner three at the buzzer. That misses with a second to go. We played one at AT&T Center with the Spurs out in front. Jay and I back with more from San Antonio after this. You're tuned into the NBA on EA Sports. Second quarter set to start. This is what we like. This game is certainly in the balance.
Yeah, both teams have came out. They play with great energy, and they've also done an excellent job of establishing their own tempo. They have to make sure they have to push through that and do more of that in the second quarter.
No good. Oh, it looked like he may have gotten him there.
And one of the most underrated things in this game is quick lateral speed. Good job by utilizing that speed and taking away the lane.
To Fultz. It's corralled by San Antonio. Spurs have it. DeJounte Murray to Gasol. Probing the defense. Has a chance. Fultz there for the rebound. Here's Simmons with it up top. Minute gone by in this second quarter. To McConnell. Embiid. Short jumper off the mark. To Murray. Justin Patton with a piece.
Ed, that's light work for a guy with his ability.
Trying to cash in, knocks it down, off the step back.
I don't know what halftime evaluation will be worst, the ankles or the bruised ego.
Spurs in possession. DeJounte Murray to Gasol. Knocks it down from mid-range.
It's going to be so intriguing to watch the development of DeJounte Murray. Remember, he just turned 22 the night before the season began, and he's still growing into his body. But he has big shoes to fill taking over the role for Tony Parker, a guy that's been so dominant for so many years with the Spurs.
Driving right to the basket. Oh, nice find for the basket.
Now that the process has been established, it's gonna be fun to see how much better Joel Embiid can be this season. Everybody heard about his arduous off-season workout program, but the thing I love about him the most, he always works on his game, even if he's dunking on random fans on vacation.
4-3, now that's a contest.
Just because you're an elite shooter doesn't mean you need to shoot the ball every possession. Maybe give a head fake, crack into the defender, get to the free throw line, see the ball go in the hole.
Murray into the front court. His team up by one. Can't connect. To McConnell. Markelle Fultz. Pau Gasol swats it. That's his third block this evening.
This game is all about playing mind tricks on people. The offense is more worried about getting their shot blocked than they are about actually making the shot.
Into the game for Philadelphia, number 8.
Fultz to Embiid. Shot clock's at 5. Down to 4. Well defended, shot no good. If it was anyone else, they'd be back on the bench for taking that shot.
Let's be realistic. He's probably not gonna miss a lot of shots, but the more effort you can give, you wanna try to tire him out. Take his legs away, make him work to catch the ball. That's how you win a defensive battle.
Gasol, now a steal by Philly. Taking advantage of the turnover. San Antonio ball. Patty Mills to Gasol. Here comes the screen. Patty Mills. Shot clock coming down to 4. Down to 3. Deep two there, won't go. Simmons with it. Leads just a point. To Embiid. And he's fouled. Couple of free throws coming up, Jay.
Aggressive play there, but you can't fault the defender for being up in the shooter. You need to contest shots, each and every one of them.
Mike Muscala at the line for 2 shots. Hasn't missed yet. First one goes down. And fails to hit them both. Hits the first, misses the second. And that one out of bounds off a spur. Substitution being made in this one. McConnell to Embiid. Doesn't get the bounce. Rudy Gay to DeRozan. Shot from the lane, won't go. Fultz into the front court. Leads a bucket. Has a look. Another chance. Basket's good on the follow. Way to stay with it.
Strong finish. That's what you need, regardless of contact, focusing on the rim.
Mills in possession. Looking to make something happen. Aldridge. Deep right corner. To DeRozan. Rudy Gay to DeRozan. Let's it fly from beyond the arc. Well defended. Tough shot for Patty Mills. Philadelphia with the basketball. McConnell to Embiid. DeRozan with it. Trailing by 4. To Aldridge. Patty Mills. able to convert inside.
I tell you, he's so special, Ed. He makes the game look easy.
A lot of hard work to make it look easy. McConnell to Fultz. The rebound taken by San Antonio. Mills in possession. They trail by two. DeRozan to Aldridge. The drive right to the basket. Five to shoot for San Antonio. Short jumper misses. Fultz with the basketball. 2-point advantage. DeRozan with the basketball. He'll run the offense. Rudy Gay to Aldridge. Old school. Backs his man down for the basket. It's in the hands of Philadelphia. Markel Fultz to Embiid. Here comes the screen. Great defense there, forcing the pickup. Oh, bad pass taken away by the Spurs.
When it's a tight game, those missed opportunities on the road make it tough.
Patty Mills to DeRozan. From the painted area, won't go down. Joel Embiid rejects it. Hustle pays off. They've got the possession. To McConnell. And a whistle.
Timing was just a tad bit off.
Looks like both teams are making substitutions.
Team foul number two. Subbing in for the Philadelphia 76ers, number eight.
McConnell. To Embiid. Big stuff and a lot of traffic on the way to the rim.
It's so amazing when you get a chance to see a player in his own space. It's almost as if the defense doesn't exist. He can go left, he can go right, he can attack. He's playing on that court by himself.
DeRozan to Aldridge. And stuffs it home. He was ready right at the tip.
What a first half he's having. He came out of the gate, attacked, found ways to get to the rim. Now look how easy the game is coming to him.
McConnell. To Embiid. Ah, missed it. How'd that not go down? Right now, San Antonio's possession. To DeRozan. Short jumper won't fall. To Embiid. Knocked loose. And that one out of bounds off a spur. So possession stays with Philadelphia. Both coaches dipping into their reserves. Changes coming onto the floor.
76ers, number 23, Jimmy Butler. Stepping in for San Antonio, number 16.
Butler defended by DeMar DeRozan to Embiid. Shot won't go. To DeRozan. Wide open look won't go. Green coming. McConnell to Butler.
Hand up.
That's rebounded by the Spurs. DeRozan to Aldridge. Knocked loose. Taken by the Sixers.
We're going to see a team take the lead here.
Butler. To McConnell. Butler to Embiid. Tough-looking shot there. Still gets it to go down.
Sometimes you hear people give all these fancy breakdowns, tell you all these different things they can do. That was just plain old simple bully basketball. Muscled his way through the lane.
Scores from the post.
Hand down, man down. You got to get up and contest the shot.
McConnell to Embiid. Got it.
Well, when you play for each other and not just for yourself, that's when great things happen. You essentially lose yourself in what the team is trying to accomplish. It's called unselfish basketball. And there's nothing more beautiful than rewarding your teammate with a nice pass and letting them finish for 2 or 3 points.
And slams it down. Big finish for Aldridge.
I don't think I could do that on a 5-foot rim.
I can, because that's my only choice. McConnell to Embiid. It's Aldridge with the rebound. San Antonio with the basketball to Aldridge. Oh, he had him there for a second. Has a chance, and he scores on the step back.
Might have had an extra dribble or two there, but he got the shot he wanted.
Number 12, LaMarcus Aldridge.
Jumper's good. Just inside the arc, at the buzzer. Yes, at the buzzer. He just managed to get it off in time. As a result, they're ahead on the scoreboard here at the end of the first half.
Thanks, Ed. The Spurs are in a close game thus far. It was their playmaking, the way they gave each other scoring opportunities. That really impresses me. I love seeing unselfish basketball like that. Have a look at the leading scores for the San Antonio Spurs. The 76ers aren't down by much after two quarters.
And even though they don't have the lead, they're doing a great job of moving the ball around. They might find themselves on the winning end of the scoreboard if they can keep it up.
Have a look at the leading scores for the Philadelphia 76ers.
Game track. Assists.
The first half is exactly what coaches want to see from their players offensively. The ball is moving, players are taking great shots, and the assist totals keep going up.
Player of the half.
LaMarcus Aldridge has the defense figured out, and his shots are falling for him.
That's a lethal combination that will be hard to overcome.
Who was cold?
No one wants to be picked for this segment, but he couldn't avoid it. Maybe he'll turn things around in the second half.
Here's our top plays from the first half.
Number two. Number one.
Back to Ed and Jay to bring you the second half action.
Spurs
Spurs have it. DeJounte Murray to Aldridge. DeRozan to Murray.
Hey, kick me the ball.
Down to 5 on the 24. DeRozan, not that time. To Simmons. Butler to Simmons. He was smothered and still gets it to go down.
Let me tell you something that nobody will ever talk about. Did you see him slow down right before he was about to go up? That slow change of speed, that slight change was just enough to throw the defender off.
The Spurs with 4 on the shot clock, beyond the arc for 3. Butler to Embiid. Yes, and the foul, and a chance at 3 coming up.
The defender was actually in a good position there. They even made a decent play on the ball, but sometimes those bounces go the other way. Still, stay aggressive out there.
Joel Embiid at the line for a chance at a 3-point play. He's struggled so far. Free throw's good. A 3-point play. And with that, they go up by 3. DeJounte Murray to Aldridge. Great dish to set it up. To Gasol, down low. Joel Embiid able to recover with the block. Sixers control it.
Blocking so many shots only gives your perimeter that much more confidence to really apply more pressure.
They'll get it down to Johnson. To Embiid. Butler. Can't connect. Rudy Gay. Down low, Aldridge. And it's Butler who grabs the rebound. Knocked loose. Picked up by the Spurs. DeJounte Murray to Gasol. Joel Embiid knocked away. It's getting dangerous down there.
And I hated getting my shot blocked like that, but I did like getting the ball right back. You know why? I don't see anybody on the defensive end standing up out of position. I see everybody squatted down, really active with their hands. That's the mentality that will lead you to where you want to go.
Aldridge. To DeRozan. To Murray. Unbothered by the defense as he drills it.
No doubt about where that one was headed.
Simmons with it. Leads just a point. Here comes the screen. Nothing going here on that drive. Simmons to the basket, but his shot stays out. DeJounte Murray, tough matchup against Butler. Knocked loose, and his foot was on the line. It's going the other way. DeRozan, down again. Nice pace, sets it up, and slams it down.
That's what I'm talking about. Nice finish. It's all business.
Sixers have the basketball. Butler to Simmons. Here comes the screen. Simmons to Butler. The shot almost.
Oh, I like that. You got the defense rotating from side to side. They're even recovering late, but still, you got to make that one.
Here comes the screen. DeRozan to Gasol. Ben Simmons with the block.
Oh, he blocked that with authority.
Into the front court comes Simmons. His guys now down by a point. To Butler. Murray into the front court. Looking to make something happen. Add 2 points to the board.
Woo, did you see that? Eyes to the rim, and the rest was all net.
Butler to bring it up. His guys down three.
Three.
To Embiid. Butler. The Sixers with four to shoot to Butler. Simmons. Ben Simmons. Consistent effort. He's at 50%.
Ooh, welcome to the new reality. Positionless basketball. Bigs are now PGs with the ability to drain threes.
Trying to cash in. He shoots. Oh, off the mark.
See, the defender did a really good job. He stayed down. He didn't go and bite for all the head fakes. He waited until the last second to contest that shot. Way to know the scouting report.
Butler picked up by DeRozan. Count the basket inside.
You know, Jimmy Buckets really has an inspiring story. From being homeless at the age of 13 before moving in with a friend, reads like a basketball version of the Blind Side. That grit has become the fabric of his DNA. From Tyler Junior College to Marquette to the 30th pick in the first round, are you kidding me? To where he is now, Jimmy Buckets has had to earn every inch that this game has given him.
Knock loose. That's out of bounds. Last touch by Murray. Both teams tweaking their lineups. Here come some changes. Simmons to Butler. Short jumper off the mark. Mills in possession. His guys find themselves trailing by a bucket. Aldridge to Patty Mills. Here's a chance from long range. It's good. Defense has to pick things up.
It's all about creating space with the dribble. Once you have that gap, you can beat somebody in a variety of ways. He chose a dagger with a three.
Butler to Simmons. To Butler. Simmons to Butler. Going to launch beyond the arc. And Jimmy Butler, all in stride. Catch and shoot three is good.
Yeah, and what we're seeing is a brilliant offensive display. You have ball movement, player movement, and great shooting to top it off. You get those three things going, you're going to be a dynamic offensive unit.
Another follow stays out.
But you can't just be a one-dimensional player. I know you're probably frustrated by me even saying that, but when you don't even give the option to pass the ball by utilizing some head fakes or ball fakes here and there, you save the defender by keeping them on their toes with the element of surprise.
Patty Mills to Gasol. From the painted area, won't go down. Butler into the front court. They lead it, 4-point game. Knocked loose. Spurs have it. Patty Mills matched up with Patton to DeRozan. Here comes the screen. Patty Mills to DeRozan. Has a look. DeMar DeRozan not looking pretty. 3 for 10.
When the ball is in his hands, we all knew what was going to happen.
Simmons into the front court. 2-point advantage. Butler up against the Spaniard. From the outside, no good.
Let's be realistic. He's probably not going to miss a lot of shots. But the more effort you can give, you want to try to tire him out. Take his legs away. Make him work to catch the ball. That's how you win a defensive battle.
Old school. Backs his man down for the basket. Here's Simmons with it up top. Tie game, third quarter. Jimmy Butler, he's 5 for 10, shooting 50%.
Did you see the way that dribble freed him up? It created so much space.
I did, but the defender didn't.
To Patty Mills. Philadelphia with the basketball. Butler defended by DeMar DeRozan. To Simmons. Able to convert inside. There's a toughness he learned under Tibbs at two stops, and no question, that rubs off on younger players.
There is something that Jimmy Butler does that no other player in the NBA does. He gets into your psyche. He gets into your head each and every possession. He enjoys the process of the fight. Every single blow, there is a pleasure in the pain.
New blood coming in for both sides.
Stepping in for Philadelphia, number 20, Markelle Fultz.
Patty Mills.
Hey, watch the screen lift.
Has a chance, knocks it down off the step back.
There you go. I like seeing his scoring coming from unlikely sources.
It's in the hands of Philadelphia. Butler, deep left corner. They'll go to Butler, down low. The jumper's off the mark.
Let's be realistic. He's probably not going to miss a lot of shots. But the more effort you can give, you want to try to tire him out. Take his legs away. Make him work to catch the ball. That's how you win a defensive battle.
Fultz into the front court. Our score all even in this third quarter. Butler matched up with Bellinelli. Shot from the lane won't go.
Yo, big kudos to the defender. It seems like his mere presence in the paint was enough to make the offensive player miss the shot before he even got off the ground.
Patty Mills. Trying to cash in. Wide open look won't go.
I don't know why he rushed that shot. He was wide open. Take your time.
To Butler. Has a look. And he hits. We talk so much about who are the MVP candidates, but there are other guys who are so valuable to their teams, and Jimmy Butler at the forefront of that list.
I have a phrase that I use when I describe players like Jimmy Butler. It's called most valuable mentality. There are certain players that approach the game with a certain mindset every single day that they will do anything, anything possible to win the ball game. He plays with his heart and soul every single possession and every night, and he will leave it on the court if that means he can win the ball game.
So Fultz, here comes the screen. Markelle Fultz, not shaken for the early struggles. Maybe this is a sign of things to come.
Oh, don't see the read, be the read.
Mills in possession. His guys trail now by four. Here comes the screen. The rebound taken down by the Sixers. Sixers control it. Butler up against Rudy Gay. To Fultz. Drives, but a shot won't go down. Fires the three. Unconventional to say the least. It's no good. Looks like some substitutions are coming on in.
Philadelphia, number eight.
Mm-hmm. Fultz with the basketball. Shot clock turned off as they try to extend the lead. Here comes the screen. Deep three at the buzzer. That's the end of the third quarter. It's the Sixers out in front. It's been a compelling game so far. The fourth quarter is underway. Sixers have the basketball.
Everyone gets free pizza.
Fultz to Butler. Can't connect. Knocked loose. Sixers have it.
Don't play scared now. Let's push the ball. Let's get this lead up.
And the finish at the rim.
You know, every time I watch Jimmy Buckets, the tenacity he plays with on the defensive end, it just reconfirms the fact that he's been named an All-Star four times. He shot a career best, 47% from the field in 2017-18. So when you think about trying to lock him up, you have to limit his touches, and you have to force him to catch the ball with his back to the basket. Make him put the ball down on the ground and make contested shots, because if you don't, Jimmy Butler will cut you apart.
Butler, guarded by Murray. Down low to Smith. Sheer strength to slam it down. He ran right through the gauntlet.
I was expecting the dish there, but way to fake that one and lay that one in.
Murray with it. His guys down by nine. Five to shoot for San Antonio. Has a chance. Not that time.
See, when good shooters catch, they just shoot. When bad shooters catch, they become hesitant, reluctant. That's the first sign of a guy that doesn't have confidence.
Curling inside. To the basket is Butler, but he can't finish.
And you see so many players quit on the play after they were beat the first time, but not him. He stayed on his hip, he fought back, and he made the player miss the shot. That's great defense.
Pau Gasol, now 4 for 9.
But most importantly, you have to keep the ball moving. Maybe run some floppy sets, some horn sets. Raise those bigs up, which open up the lane, and let them be the passers to make plays easier for the guards.
To Butler. No good. To Gasol. Short jumper won't go down.
You know, Ed, everybody gives so much credit to the guy who contested the shot, but there's no way he's in that position without the communication of the backbone of the defense. When you have a guy back there who can block shots and tells you to apply more pressure, you know you're in a safe place.
No good. Butler to bring it up. His team up by 7. Markelle Fultz. Tough shooting. Only 2 for 6 after that make.
I don't know if the scouting report has made its way out here yet, but if anything, it says you need to not let him get that close to the rim.
I got him.
DeJounte Murray. Here comes the screen. Bellinelli matched up with Patton to Murray. The Spurs with 4 in the shot clock. For 3, he was all over him.
And look, sometimes you don't have it going every single night. Maybe utilize yourself as a decoy and get some teammates involved with your passing.
To Butler. Markelle Fultz. That's rebounded by San Antonio. Trying to cash in. Missed that one. His coach cannot be at.
Oh! Out there looking like the Kimbe Mutombo.
Took it right to him, and the defender was ready.
Oh, I see how you're playing this chess match. That's what you keep doing defensively. Keep baiting him and luring him into shooting that jump shot. Exploit him.
Now whistle. San Antonio is going to use a timeout as they'll talk things over here in this fourth quarter. Changes coming from both sides right now. DeRozan sizing up Butler. To Murray. The shot clock expires. Butler picked up by DeRozan. Scores from the post.
Old school equals high percentage.
Murray with the basketball. The deficit now up to 13. Nothing going here on that.
Whoa, look what I found. You know it's a bad block when somebody snatches the ball out of the air. Wow.
To Butler. Oh, great defense there, forcing the pickup. Fultz to Embiid. Fultz. Off the iron. No good. Has a look. DeRozan with a shot off the mark.
You know, Ed, everybody gives so much credit to the guy who contested the shot, but there's no way he's in that position without the communication of the backbone of the defense. When you have a guy back there who can block shots and tells you to apply more pressure, you know you're in a safe place.
Butler. Murray into the front court. His guy's currently down by 13. Good look that time, but off the mark.
But you can't just be a one-dimensional player. I know you're probably frustrated by me even saying that, but when you don't even give the option to pass the ball by utilizing some head fakes or ball fakes here and there, you save the defender by keeping them on their toes with the element of surprise.
Five on the shot clock for Philadelphia. Jimmy Butler for two. Murray into the front court. His guys trail by 13. DeRozan to Gasol. Five to shoot for San Antonio. Has a chance. The screen sets him up for two.
Clearly not afraid of the spotlight here because that was not an easy look.
Fultz into the front court. It's an 11-point game. Butler defended by DeMar DeRozan. To Fultz. Slams it down. Big finish for Joel Embiid.
I know there's that old saying that says one man can't beat five, but we're watching one man carry four other players. His back has to be hurting. Another big time finish.
Both coaches hitting the reset button. Fresh legs coming onto the floor. DeRozan to Rudy Gay. The Spurs with four in the shot clock. Trying to cash in. He buries it, creating space with the step back.
Ooh, cool, calm, and collective. The three C's. His handles are effortless.
Here comes the screen.
Hey, hey, hey. Screen, screen, screen.
To Fultz. From the painted area, won't go down. Rudy Gay to DeRozan. Rudy Gay to DeRozan. Short jumper stays out. Nice follow-up on the dunk there. He's been a one-man show, but Jay, they're still down in this one.
He's their lone bright star, their only star tonight. Some other of the supporting cast members really need to step up.
Has a look. Markel Fultz. Oh, 3 for 8. He's got to do better. Spurs in possession. DeRozan to Aldridge. That's rebounded by Philadelphia. Smith with the basketball. The lead is 11 to Fultz. Here comes the screen. Markel Fultz to Embiid. Down to 5 on the 24 to Fultz. Has a chance. Add 2 points to the board.
Well, we got a chance to firsthand watch something be created. I think we just watched an epidemic of passing. I've never seen something like this before. It was so contagious, everybody started to do it, and it ultimately led to the other team's demise.
If that's an epidemic, sign me up. Smith with it up top. His team on top by 13. Won't go down. Murray with it. Looking to make something happen. DeRozan. Not that time. He missed it. To Fultz. Second effort.
You know, some guys love the flash, other guys love the grind. Well, Amir Johnson is a guy that always shows up to work with his hard hat on. That's the reason why he won the Hustle Award last season, for giving maximum effort every time he stepped his foot on that floor.
DeJounte Murray to DeRozan. It's Embiid with the rebound.
The game is won in the details. The team who has the most attention to the minutia is a team that wins the ball game. And from the beginning of this game, this team has been mentally engaged. I know the season's a long year, but when you come mentally engaged and you have attention to detail...
Oh, and a putback.
Ooh, really showing no mercy here. This one is out of hand, and the offense is still pouring it on.
DeJounte Murray to DeRozan. Aldridge to DeRozan. Trying to cash in. DeRozan with a shot that misses. From long range. Won't go down. Amir Johnson sends it away.
Ed, that's light work for a guy with his ability.
Fultz. Has a look. And he knocks it down, Jay.
You know, it reminds me, Ed, of a story a legendary coach once told me. He said, if you ever get in a fight, you're not going to hit somebody with an open hand, correct? You'll probably break a finger. But if you hit somebody with a fist, what is that? That's five fingers working collectively together as one. That's how you deliver a knockout punch, and that's what we're seeing tonight.
Philadelphia with the basketball to Fultz. Sizing up the defense. Here comes the screen. Markelle Fultz. Fires the three. DeRozan's got the board. They've got the rebound. And now in transition, the Sixers are victorious as they win this one handily. That'll wrap things up. For Jay Williams and our entire crew, I'm Ed Cohen. This has been a presentation of the NBA on EA Sports.
Taylor Rose here, and I've got your EA Sports post-game wrap-up. The 76ers were solid in today's victory. They did it with blocks, and they did it with steals. More to the point, they did it with excellent defense. They committed to the grind and got rewarded as a result. What you see here is how the majority of the points were scored for the Philadelphia 76ers. The Spurs just couldn't get within striking distance toward the end of the game. And even though some of them smiled and shook hands with the other guys after the game, you could tell by the way they headed to the tunnels how disappointed they were about this loss. Here are the guys who put up the most points for the San Antonio Spurs.
Game track. Bench points.
The Philadelphia 76ers had the kind of bench production that will make any coach proud. NBA games can be made easier when you're working with depth, and that's exactly what happened here today.
Player of the game.
Joel Embiid
was happy to throw down plenty of dunks, and if the defense happened to be there, he brought them along for the ride.
Who was cold?
What can you say about a guy like this, except that he fits the title of this segment? He was definitely cold in this game. These are the top plays of the game.
Number two. Number one.
The upcoming matchups for the San Antonio Spurs. This has been a presentation of ESPN on EA Sports. Until next time, I'm Jalen Rose, signing off.